cop who acted insane, ridiculous, punching the car of a woman that he pulled over? Well, we have the exclusive update. He has now been fired. Let me take you directly to that video again.
Driver's license, ma'am.
You just punched my car. Why did you just punch my car, sir?
Ma'am, driver's license, please.
You just punched my car. Why did you just punch my car? And why do you? Okay, I'll get you the driver's license. Why did you just punch my car?
Driver's license.
My car was recording. Why were you? Okay, I am getting my license. Why did you just, Sergeant Baker?
Driver's license.
What? Let me see your. Let me see your.
Driver's license.
Don't put your hand in my car.
Driver's license now.
Don't put your hand in my car.
Driver's license now.
One second. You wait.
Driver's license now. Driver's license.
So can you tell me why you
Driver's license. Driver's license. Driver's license. Driver's license.
So Lieutenant Wright.
Driver's license.
This is for you and
driver's license. Driver's license.
I am giving him my license.
Driver's license. Driver's license, please.
And I asked him,
ma'am,
I just
please,
went
can you give me your driver's license?
I already made a complaint.
Ma'am,
with
can you
Tasha
give me
Mosley
your driver's license?
Today,
ma'am, can you give me your driver's license?
I already complained
ma'am,
about him.
Ma'am, can you give me your driver's
license? One second,
license?
Sir. You're
ma'am, can you give
irate.
Me your driver's license?
One second.
Ma'am, can you give me your driver's
one
license?
One second.
Ma'am,
and
can
he's
you give
being
me your
very
driver's
irate.
License?
He went
ma'am,
past.
Can you give me your driver's
he went
license?
Past and he hit
ma'am, can you give me your
my
driver's
car.
License? Ma'am, driver's license.
He went past
driver's
and hit my
license.
Car. Why did you go past
driver's
me?
License.
When I find it.
Driver's license.
You have to wait till I find it.
I'm about.
There's more. Wait, before we go to it. Remember, this cop has already punched her car walking up to it, and it created a significant dent. If the damage is more than $250 in the state of Georgia, which it did look as if it was more than 250, that's a felony. So you have an officer likely walking up to this woman, already committed one felony, and now he's screaming like this, but there's more background to their relationship. Here it is.
Break your window.
Okay.
I'm about to
break my window, sir.
Driver's license.
Sir, break my
driver's
window.
Driver's license.
Break the
driver's
window, sir.
License.
Break
now.
Break the window, sir.
Driver's license.
Sir, break my window, please.
Driver's license. Now. You got 3 seconds. You got 3 seconds.
Yes.
3 seconds for your driver's
and
license.
And I'm sitting here.
One.
And this is the same sergeant I made a complaint on.
Driver's license.
And I'm sitting here pregnant, and I'm sitting here pregnant. He's busting. You don't have to bust my window.
Then
I'll give you my license when I get it.
You are recording this?
I will give you my license when I get it. I will give you my license when I get it.
Two. Driver's license now.
So he's starting to hit it.
License now.
He's starting to hit my car. Yes. This is the same one I made a complaint on. Yes, and he's in with Tasha Mosley, and this is the one I have the lawsuit on. So I went past and he hit my car. And this young man right here was on duty as well. Sir, can you tell me your name?
Driver's license.
It's on the ground.
Driver's license.
Hit my, bust this window.
Okay, you saw what happened. And according to her, the individual who was being accosted by this cop, she has a complaint, an active complaint against him. Let's put up his picture full mass. We have the update. Sergeant Johnny Baker. And it's so sad he's a sergeant. That means he's a supervisor. He passed the sergeant's test. Sergeant Johnny Baker of the Lovejoy, Georgia Police Department was fired. Thursday evening, a police officer connected with the department told Indisputable directly. As we previously reported, the pregnant black woman who recorded the incident had a history of being harassed by this same sergeant. She already issued a complaint against that sergeant and has an ongoing lawsuit. Let's put up the chief. Lovejoy Police Chief Michael A. Gaddis suspended Sergeant Baker and placed him on administrative leave pending an internal investigation. Here's Chief Gaddis and Mayor Bob Cartwright. Now, that investigation actually concluded yesterday. A source in the city says the mayor, Cartwright, requested the sergeant be completely removed from duty. Chief Gaddis confirmed with Indisputable, Sergeant Baker's employment has now been terminated with the Lovejoy Police Department on November 10th. We were the first ones to cover this as a news agency. Nobody else had covered it at that point nationally. It was making the rounds on social media. Details were difficult to come by. But do you think that person should be a cop? Of course not. Do you think he should supervise cops? Hell no. And this is why it's important for transparency to reign supreme. Now, I gotta give credit where credit is due. How do you think we got this story? We got this story, we got to the bottom of this because individuals who decided to talk with us, who do wear a uniform, badge, and gun every day, they went directly in conversation with us about what actually happened because bad cops gotta go. All right, Dan, thoughts here?
It's a really good ending to the story in the sense that clearly, and we've seen in a lot of cases, especially recently, where you have cops who are their first point to seeing someone is in arrest is with deadly force, with a threat. Like there was that poor man who was like shot multiple times in his car driving away from McDonald's a couple weeks ago or a couple months ago. Mm-hmm. Like there needs to be a right for people, understandably, to want to protect themselves from undue, unnecessary assault from these armed police officers who are out there. And so yes, it's very good. It's giving me a little bit more hope when you see officers who are willing to stand up and say, no, I need to root this out of our department. We need to show that we are better than this. We need to actually protect and serve our citizens. The only thing I want to see now is usually you see people like this bounced across police departments across the state or across the country. There needs to now be a blacklist for people like this. I don't want them to even be a security guard. I barely want them to even be like a manager at a Little Caesars. This people like this should not have authority, and we need to make sure that is down the line, at least not until they get serious counseling.
Well said.